So would you first like to introduce yourself, please?
I am Dan. I am the editing chief and co-writer for the series.
I'm Alexander, and I write the series.
Okay, thank you very much. Would you mind answering some questions? Well, that's what you're here to do.
So. That's what we're here for. Let's get on with it.
Okay, so first question is from a LES member called David Beer. How did you pick which calls you recorded? It might be an interesting question for him.
Yeah, that's a good question. So what we did here was we, at the start of each shift, we were given a crew to follow. So there were two cameramen in total. So that meant we could film two crews throughout their shift. And we basically filmed the entire shift and picked what we felt was appropriate for that episode from what they'd obviously attended that day. And obviously some crews had good calls, some were just kind of the usual elderly faller, drunk person, you know. But we tried our best to keep the calls well balanced. We didn't want it all trauma and action packed, but we didn't also want it all dull and boring, if you get me.
Yep, that's fair enough. Any another answer from Alexandra at all?
Yeah, I just think series was to show what service do, not just action packed stuff. So I think we had a good balance.
Yeah, thank you very much. On to the next one. This is a question from Jackie Weaver.
Jackie. Sorry. Yeah.
Did the plan of filming a day and night shift go down well with the LAS staff?
The LAS staff were very welcoming, I could put it. They're mostly all up for it, and they just continue doing their job, even though there was a camera crew in their face, give or take. I think the night and the day shift showed a good balance between what really happens at different times of the day, because during the night you obviously get a lot more trauma because it's dark, you can't see what you're doing. And it's the perfect time for assaults, muggings, car crashes, like that. And then during the day, it's kind of bright daylight, so there's very little assaults and muggings and stuff like that during the day. So I think it's a good balance. I think it worked well.
Anything to add?
No, just exactly what Dan here said.
Okay, so was any of you at the scenes of certain calls? Was any of you there?
Yeah.
So, for the first few scenes, some of the production staff, as well as the cameramen, turned up just to make sure filming was going well, but also that the privacy of patients was respected.
Yeah, that's pretty much what I was going to say. To be fair, we did like to attend the scenes ourselves for some of them, just to ensure that it was all going to plan.
So added on from that, would you please what you see from the staff members of the LAS while you were recording? Did they take that as a distraction, or did they just get on with their job and ignore the cameras?
I think they just got on with it most of the time, you know. I think they didn't really change their behaviour as such, even though they were being filmed. They were still, professional as could be, and they did make sure that the treatment of the patient was the primary goal here. It wasn't to look good on TV, you get me.
Hey, so this is a question from Michael Brown from Leicester. What made you want to film this special series? We know you did one in Norfolk, Norwich, but what
yes.
made you do another one?
Well, that's a good question, actually. So originally, we had filmed, obviously, season one, which was based in Norfolk following the Eastern England Ambulance Service. And I just thought, you know, London, it's a nice built-up place. There's a nice variety of calls. And I think that it was a good place to just film another series, because the first series was an absolute blast. It was a hit and everything, you know. Got over 10,000 views on the first series. And I thought, you know, that went really well. People liked it. They kept asking for more. So we decided London is the perfect place to do a second series.
Well, adding on from that, just a quick calculation. It actually had around 12.2 views, I think. 12.2, I think it is.
12.2?
Yeah, well, yeah, whatever it is. But yeah, let's move on.
Actually, that means thousands.
Okay, so the last series had around 12,200 views. I've just worked that out.
Mm-hmm.
So that went down well. So you just decided to have another shot in a different area, I guess, then?
Yeah, unfortunately, we were unable to film the decent enamelment service again. I would have loved to do it again, but, you know, because we've already done the first series with them, we wanted to explore more areas.
Yeah.
But don't get me wrong, we'd love to do East of England again.
Right. Moving on from that, this is a question for myself. Did you have any interference from the public?
Yeah, quite a bit. The public were quite shocked, I think, to see not just the ambulance services, but cameras following them around. It was out of the ordinary.
Yeah, I agree. I think, personally, the patients and the family of the patients, they were, you know, obviously we had to notify them that they were being filmed and stuff due to privacy reasons, but, you know, they were brilliant. You know, they didn't interfere. We didn't interfere with them. And it all round just worked well, apart from, if we were filming in public, there would be a few people that would come and, you know, jump in the camera's face. But that's expected, isn't it? It's the British public. You know? But we worked around it.
That is completely understandable. Right, cut here for a minute. I was meant to have biology, but, you know, we move on.
I must say, these seats are very comfy.
I was about to say that as well.
Right, okay. Scoot your box. Wait, let me just right. Anyway, a question for both of you, please. Can you just do half and half? Did you worry if there's going to be any effect on the London Ambulance Service to the care they provided while you was recording them?
Absolutely not.
Yeah, I didn't think it would affect them to doing their jobs. I think, you know, we pitched the right crews to film, and, you know, like, it's a difficult question because obviously you can't really read their minds. You can't tell whether they were going to act like different. But from what I saw, they just did their job as normal and got on with it.
Yeah.
You know, it was like we weren't there.
Yeah, well, seems pretty good. Question for Alexandra: did it open your eyes up to what goes on the 999 calls? Like, did it open your eyes up to what they actually face every day?
As you said earlier, I was the assistant producer of season one, but I think in London there's a much higher level of more violent assaults. So knife crime, muggings, it's much more prevalent in London, especially in poorer areas.
The concept of why you wanted to record it, was it to get the message out there or just give an insight of what they do?
Yeah, so I think that obviously it's one reason we wanted to do it was obviously because, you know, season one was such a good hit. And we just want the people kept saying they really enjoyed it, they'd moved by it. However, another reason why we did decide was because we did want to get a message across about, you know, mental health, NHS abuse, you know what I mean? Like, the stuff that's going on in the world currently. We tried to make this so it would get a message across to the viewers.
Yeah.
You know, that things are happening and they need to be sorted.
Yeah, makes sense. Anything from you, Alexandra?
No, just what Dan said. I mean, the mental health crisis, it grows every day and it needs urgent attention.
Yeah, sure does. Yeah, okay, thank you very much. Coming up after the break now, questions with one of the LAS staff, John Darson. Please join us for that after the break.
back time, do it all over again. Tomorrow we can press rewind. We're staying at the Lotus.
Welcome back from the lovely break you just had. We hope you are still with us and not gone elsewhere. We are now joined by John Dawson, Alexander and Daniel. John Dawson, I believe you are. Can you just introduce yourself and who you are and what you do?
A technician from the London Ambulance Service. I basically work along with paramedics.
Did you put any pressure while the BBC crew were recording you?
Well, not at all. Other situations, I just ignore the camera throughout, and then just help the patients.
Did you enjoy the series and watch yourself back on TV?
Yeah, I did enjoy the series. There were some times I was a bit nervous watching me speaking in front of the camera and to my patients. But overall, yeah, I did really like the series of BBC Ambulance.
Thank you. This is a question for both of you. Would you rather anyone was going to either question or hate on the producer or one of the AS staff for what they've done during the series or a mistake they made?
Sorry, could you repeat the start? I didn't hear it.
Would you write about any hate on social media or in the comments about anything one of the paramedics has done wrong or the producer has recorded that shouldn't have been recorded?
Okay, that's a sensible question, I suppose. I didn't have any concerns about, obviously, hate or anything, because unfortunately it's part of society now where, you know, if you post something and it gets popular, you're going to get haters wherever you go. Mm-hmm. And I think I don't listen to the haters, because if they hate it so much, there's no need to watch it. Just get on with your day. Don't waste your time watching my show if you're going to hate it. Do you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Like, and I think it's disrespectful to all of the hard work that the LAS staff and the film crew went through. You know, it's just a bit.
There's really no point if you're going to drop a comment.
You know, if you have a problem, then, you know, you can contact us via our Discord or our Twitter and we can talk to you about it. But if you're just going to spread unnecessary hate around, you know, our channel and our kind of, you know, our hobby, basically, the things we like to do. You know, if you're going to do that, then we're just going to straight up get rid of you, you know? I mean, personally, I removed plenty of people from the viewing of Ambulance because they were being rude to other people in the Premier chat and stuff, innit?
That kind of comes on to my next question. Did you receive any hate, or was it mostly good?
Oh, yeah. To be fair, though, I will be honest, we probably 99% of it was, you know, it was great feedback. People loved it. We had constructive criticism. You know, I don't mind a bit of constructive criticism. I'm all ears for it because, you know, eventually that's what makes the show better. But obviously there is the minority, what, like 1-2% of the viewers that clearly weren't a fan of it. But, you know, if they didn't like it, like I said, they should have just left. There was no need to be there.
Okay. Kind of question for both of you now. One for the producer more.
All right, yeah.
Is there any more? Would there be another one?
Oh, that is I was expecting that question at some point. I think we have got our plans. All right, that's all I can really say at the moment. Yeah. But we've got our plans.
Right. Okay. John, do you think do you want more? Or do you think no?
More from BBC Ambulance, indeed. Yes, I do love.
So that's that. Thank you for joining us. We hope to give you more of an insight of what they recorded and why I've done it, and if there'll be another series, fingers crossed there will be, because I really enjoyed it.
Glad to hear.
Thank you for joining us again. Please contact
us welcome.
On our social media. I believe it's BBC Roblox on Twitter. For any questions or queries you may have or concerns. But thank you for joining us once again, and have a good rest of your night.